Christian, welcome to iFilm.
Thank you.
I left this movie, and you cannot say this about a lot of actors, but I was thinking, there is no trace of the guy that played Batman in this movie.
Right, no, nor should there be. That would be a huge mistake, yeah.
This is true, but you often see people morph. You know, there's an element of actors in all of their roles, but you, it was pretty incredible. You've never been in the military. You didn't grow up in South Central. What did you do to get into the mind of this guy?
I just hung out with the people. You know, I hung out 24/7. We had the movie was shot in a real kind of guerrilla movie making style. I loved that because also following on from Batman, you know, we'd shot for 7 months straight. It's a very very stylized kind of movie making. This is a much more gritty, raw, handheld. You know, we shot it in 24 days. You need that because the thing that's great about the movie is the momentum, the energy. It's just ceaseless. The guy is relentless. You know, he just does not stop until the very end. That's when he suddenly gets some kind of clarity, and by then it's too late. Likewise with the preparation. You know, I think we had maybe a month, and just every day I was over in East LA. I was with Dave, who's you know, it's kind of inspired by him.
Right.
Went and met and spoke with extensively with military personnel, people returning from Iraq, picked their brains, just got to know them. I had to learn that military mind. I had to learn the body language and the vernacular as well, because that's something that Jim is so good at. And then also primarily the Chicano culture too, you know, and just immersing myself in that. And that just that really just means you just go live it, you know. You go live with those people, and hang out with them and drink with them and go driving on the streets with them, and you just kind of learn what it is to be part of that world.
Is there a moment, is there a story that you heard on the streets or from these people that you kind of kept coming back to?
There were a number of stories, but they're all things which I kind of feel like I have an honor code not to pass on to anybody.
Fair
because
enough.
There were a number of things with guys from the streets, with like ex gangbangers and things who were helping us and talking with us and advising us. Many stories coming from their past. And likewise with the military, you know, you'd have some people who absolutely, you know, they were just black and white, like, nope, I'm a soldier, I don't get affected by this, this whole PTSD thing is non-existent. And others who said, no, that's not the case, you know, that they know many people like that and told me their own stories. But I would never repeat any of them. These were intensely personal, painful stories that they had, and I was very honored that they chose to share them with me.
It took several years for David to get the financing for the film, and you stood by the script and you said, I want to play this guy. Was there something about the role that you felt like you had never done before that you really wanted to...
I've certainly never played a role like this one before, no. I mean, that was a great attraction. But it was also just the nature of the way that Dave wanted to go about making this. When I first met with him, it was going to be a studio piece. And then he was very unhappy with what he was being told he had to do, the changes he had to make. And this is a very personal piece to Dave, you know. Mm-hmm. He wrote this, I believe, even before training day. It's something which he feels is the movie, is the story which is most personal to him out of anything he's ever written. It's a piece of his soul, is what he would say. And so he really wanted to make it his own way. And ultimately, the financing came straight from his back pocket, you know. And I loved that. I loved the fact that he was going against all intelligent advice, that you never put your own money in the movies. It just showed that his heart and soul was truly into this.
My last question. I know you are a pretty intensely private person. You love to kind of stay out of the limelight, but also... Were you concerned that Batman would change your life? And
I was concerned about it, but it really hasn't. It's been great, you know. I mean, it's given me the opportunity. Like you were saying, harsh times, we had kind of had it on the boil for a couple of years, and it hadn't really happened. I'm sure that Batman had a great deal to do with when I called Dave and said, come on, let's do it now. I'm sure that that was helping. There was another movie I made with Werner Herzog that had been on the boil for a few years. I don't think it's a coincidence that after I'd made Batman, bang, we got the green light for it straight away. And as for my own personal life, you know what? I'm just blessed that it really hasn't changed. I mean, truly, it really hasn't. I do exactly the same things. I'm walking around doing all the kind of normal stuff that I always did. You know, it's been as good as it could have been in my mind. You know, because I never wanted to have my life changed by that.